وكذلك قول ما شاء الله وشئت.
And also a person saying whatever Allah willed and whatever you will.
هذا من الشرك الأصغر.
And this is from a minor form of shirk.
نعم. بهذا انتهينا ولله الحمد من الناقض الأول من نواقض الإسلام.
And by mentioning this, we are finished from the first matter which invalidates a person's Islam.
من يذكر لي ما أخذنا في هذا الناقض؟
So who can now mention the things which we have taken or studied regarding this first matter which invalidates a person's Islam?
نعم.
نعم.
البقية لم يحضروا معنا.
The rest of you, you weren't present here.
اتفقنا على المشاركة.
We have agreed that all of us have to take part.
نعم.
Five things, for example, of this topic. So, for example, we follow the Quran, the Sunnah, the Salaf. Why we began with Bismillah?
Allah iftah alayk. Now,
so the brother mentioned, may Allah bless him, that why we should start off with Bismillah, the five matters.
نعم قلنا سبب البدء بالبسملة. لماذا يبدأ علماء أهل السنة والجماعة بالبسملة في مؤلفاتهم؟
So we said that why do the scholars always begin their works or their writings with mention the name of Allah? And we said five matters, or five reasons.
بالكتاب العزيز.
Following the guidance of the book, the Quran.
وبالنبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
Following the guidance of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وعلماء السلف.
And following the guidance of the great scholars of the previous generations.
تيمنا وتبارك البدع بسم الله.
And also in seeking blessings by beginning with the name of Allah.
استئناسا بالحديث وكلا صح.
And also using the hadith, and the Sheikh said istinasan, meaning using the hadith only as a supporting evidence, not as an evidence itself, even though some of the scholars said that the hadith is weak.
ما هو الناقض الأول؟
So what is the first matter which invalidates a person's Islam?
هذا أمر واضح.
This is something which is very clear.
نعم. الشرك في عبادة الله. فتح الله عليك. نعم.
الشرك in the worship of Allah. May Allah bless you.
أي الشرك الأكبر أو الأصغر أو الشرك الأكبر أو الأصغر.
Does this refer to شرك أكبر and أو أصغر or both of them?
ثلاث اختيارات.
So you got three choices.
الشرك الأكبر.
Either the major form of شرك.
أو الشرك الأصغر.
Or the minor form of شرك.
أو الشرك الأكبر والأصغر.
Or both شرك أكبر and أصغر.
ماذا أراد المؤلف هنا بالناقض في قوله الشرك في عبادة الله؟
What did the author intend when he said that the first matter which invalidates a person's Islam is a shirk. Which one of these three choices?
نعم. الشرك الأكبر. فتح الله عليك.
الشرك الأكبر.
نعم. إذا قصد المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى هنا الشرك الأصغر، مع أننا ذكرنا أن لا بد على الموحد أن يحذر من الشرك سواء كان أكبر أو أصغر، لأن الأصغر يؤدي للأكبر. نعم.
قصد المؤلف الشرك الأكبر.
نعم. قصد المؤلف الشرك الأكبر.
So like we mentioned that the author here, may Allah merge upon him, he intended by the first matter which invalidates the person's Islam is shirk akbar, major shirk. However, we mention as Muslims, we have to be careful of and be cautious of both forms of shirk. Shirk akbar and shirk asghar.
أنواع الشرك كم؟
What are the types of shirk?
نعم ذكرنا.
We just mentioned, what are the types of shirk?
ما هي أنواع الشرك؟ نعم. أكبر فتح الله عليك. نعم.
As the young brother mentioned, shirk akbar, major form of shirk, and minor shirk.
ما هو الفرق بين الشرك الأكبر والشرك الأصغر؟
So what is the difference between shirk akbar and shirk asghar?
نعم. الأكبر.
الأكبر يخرج.
مخرج من الملة، والأصغر غير مخرج من الملة.
So as the brother mentioned, that shirk akbar, the major form of shirk, it exits a person out of the fold of Islam, and shirk asghar, minor shirk, it doesn't exit the person out of the fold of Islam.
نعم. الثاني. الأكبر محبط لجميع الأعمال.
Secondly, that shirk akbar invalidates all of the actions.
الأصغر محبط للعمل الخاص.
And as for shirk asghar, it only invalidates that particular action.
مبيح للدم والمال.
That shirk akbar, it makes a person's blood and wealth permissible.
غير مبيح للدم والمال من السلطان.
And as for shirk asghar, then it's not the case with shirk asghar, and this refers to the right of the ruler, the Muslim ruler.
Al-akbar mukhallad fi an-nar khulud abadi, nasallahu alayhi wa sallam al-afiyah. And the al-asghar ghayr mukhallad khulud abadi.
And the person who has shirk akbar, then this person enters into the fire forever, and we ask Allah for safety and pardoning. However, the person who has shirk asghar, minor shirk, he doesn't enter forever into hell.
أن ينص عليه في نصوص الكتاب والسنة أنه أكبر أو أصغر.
Or that in the Quran, the Sunnah, we find a text stating that this is shirk akbar, this is shirk asghar.
إذا اعتقد أن له تصرف خوف الكون وإذا جلب المنافع دفع المضار فهذا أكبر.
If a person believes that this person he has any say or any control over the affairs of the world or changing of the world, if a person believes that this person he himself can bring out some good or he himself can repel some harm, all of this comes under shirk akbar.
إذا أثبت أو إذا اعتقد أنه سبب والله سبحانه وتعالى ما يجعله سبب فهذا أصغر.
And if a person believes for something to be a cause for something to happen, and yet Allah hasn't made it a cause for something to happen,
كل ما كان وسيلة الأكبر فهو أصغر.
And then this is shirk asghar. And then everything which is an avenue towards shirk akbar, everything, every action which leads to shirk akbar is shirk asghar.
كل ما أطلق الشرع عليه أنه شرك أو كفر أو لم يعرف بألف فهو أصغر.
And every matter that the Sharia has said that this is shirk or kufr, but in the Sharia it isn't mentioned al aitha shirk or hasn't specified it or made it definite, then this is a minor form of shirk.
نعم وإذا عرف بألف فهو أكبر.
If however that term that this is shirk is meant as shirk with the alif lam is being defined, then this is shirk akbar.
ما حكم من صرف شيء من العبادة لغير الله.
What is the ruling of the person who directs any act of worship to other than Allah?
نعم. مشرك شرك أكبر. نعم.
That this person is a mushrik who has شرك أكبر. Major form of shirk.
نعم. نريد أمثلة على الشرك الأكبر.
So we want examples for the major form of shirk.
نعم. أمثلة على الشرك الأكبر.
Major forms of shirk. Examples for the major form of shirk. الذبح.
الذبح لغير الله لكن بضابط قلنا قد يذبح حتى يأكل أو يذبح حتى يبيع هذا اللحم هذا ذبح جائز. الذبح لغير الله محبة وتعظيم أو الذبح للجن ولأصحاب القبور. نعم.
So the brother mentioned sacrificing and the sheikh said we say sacrificing for other than the sake of Allah with conditions or with restrictive factors. And that is that sacrificing for other than Allah out of love and out of exalting. If however a person sacrifices in order he can eat, or if a person sacrifices so he can sell the meat, then this is permissible. And the Shaykh mentioned that another example of sacrificing for other than the sake of Allah, which is Shirk Akbar, is a person sacrificing for a jinn. A person sacrificing for a person who is in the grave.
Dua al-ibadah.
And also we mentioned Dua al-ibadah.
Shirk Akbar.
Which is Shirk Akbar.
دعاء المسألة فيما لا أقدر عليه إلا الله.
And also requesting something from somebody who doesn't have the ability to give you that thing. This is also shirk akbar.
كطلب الولد مثلا أو إنزال الغيث.
So for example, a person requesting for rain to be sent from a person or requesting a child from a person.
وأخذنا كذلك أمثلة على الشرك الأصغر الرياء.
And we took examples. We also took examples of minor shirks such as showing off.
والحلف بغير الله.
And taking a vow by other than Allah.
وقول ما شاء الله وشئت.
And saying whatever Allah wills and you will.
نعم. الناقض الثاني.
Yes, the second matter which invalidates a person's Islam. The author Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimullah he mentioned second, whoever sets up intermediaries between himself and Allah, supplicating to them, requesting intercession from them and relying upon them, such a person has disbelieved by ijma, i.e. according to the consensus or the agreement of the scholars.
نعم. ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى في الناقض الثاني ما وقع فيه الكفار الذين بعث فيهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So in this second matter which the author mentioned, he mentioned the action or the shirk which the disbelievers at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that they fell into.
وهذا من حسن الترتيب في النواقض عند المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى. في الناقض الأول ذكر الشرك في عبادة الله.
So this is or this shows the ability of the author in terms of how he sets out these matters which invalidates a person in Islam. So the first thing that he mentioned was a shirk in worship.
نعم لأنه قد يقول لك هذا الذي قد أتى نسأل الله السلام عافية بناقض وناقض الإسلام قد يقول لك أنا لا أعبد هؤلاء أريد منهم القربة والشفاعة.
Because a person who falls into this type of shirk, i.e. making wasa'it, intermediaries or shafa'a, intercession, a person might say that, look, I don't worship those things, I'm directing this act of worship. I'm not worshipping them, but I only direct these actions to them so they can take me closer to Allah. I only direct these acts to them so they can intercede for me on behalf of Allah.
نعم ونتلو على الآيات في أن هذا هو قول الكفار وبهذا كفرهم الله سبحانه وتعالى ما نعبدهم إلا ليقربونا إلى الله زلفى هؤلاء شفعاؤنا عند الله.
And this person says this, we recite upon him the verses of the ayat which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned regarding the disbelief of the mushrikeen at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That this is what they used to say. And yet despite them saying this, using this doubt and this argument, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala still called them disbelievers. For example, the saying of Allah, that Allah said, وَمَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ
مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لِيُقَرِّبُونَ اللَّهِ زُلْفَ
مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ, that we don't really worship these objects except that they should take us close to Allah. والآية الثانية
هؤلاء شفعاؤنا عند الله.
And that the mushrikeen at the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, they say that these objects, they're only forms of intercession to Allah.
نعم ثم بعد هذا ذكر ما تعلق بالتوكل.
And then after this, the author, he mentioned that which relates to التوكل, I reliance.
التوكل الذي صرف لغير الله هو الشرك أكبر هو الاعتماد مطلق وتفويض جميع أموره إليه واعتقاد أن بيدي جلب المنافع دفع المضر هذا صرف لغير الله شرك أكبر لا بد من الاعتماد المطلق على الله سبحانه وتعالى واعتقاد أن الله سبحانه وتعالى هو الذي بيدي جلب المنافع ودفع المضر من اعتمد اعتماد مطلق على غير الله في كل أحواله نعم واعتقد أن بيده جلب المنافع دفع المضار فهذا مشرك شرك أكبر في أي باب في باب التوكل وعلى الله فتوكلوا نعم
So the author mentioned التوكل reliance and that this can also be a form of shirk and the sheikh said that the form of توكل reliance which is shirk is for somebody to totally rely on something else besides Allah
نعم اعتماد مطلق في كل أموره
I person in all of his affairs he relies on other than Allah.
واعتقاد أن بيدي جلب المنافع ودفع المضار.
And that he believes that this person or this thing it can bring about some good or it can repel some evil.
نعم والتوكل يعرف بأنه صدق الاعتماد على الله سبحانه وتعالى مع الثقة به والأخذ بالأسباب المشروعة ثلاث أشياء صدق الاعتماد على الله.
So التوكل reliance. It can be defined as something which compromises of three things. Number one, صدق الاعتماد على الله. That somebody truly relies on Allah.
مع الثقة به.
And at the same time trusting Him, having trust in Him.
أي أن يثق أن الله سبحانه وتعالى منجز له هذا. نعم, لا محالة.
And meaning that a person has complete trust in Allah, that Allah will bring this thing for him. And this isn't impossible.
وَالْأَخْذِ بِالْأَسْبَابِ الْمَشْرُوعَ عَلَى الْمَمْنُوعَ
And then the third matter which comes under true reliance is using those avenues or those causes which Allah has placed upon this earth.
مثاله
So an example of this is
هذا الأخ
This brother
يريد أن يحفظ القرآن
This brother, he wants to memorize the Quran.
وقال أنا متوكل على الله.
And he says that I am somebody who relies upon Allah.
وكان صادق في هذا الكلام لا كاذب.
And he's truthful in this speech, in this statement. He's not lying.
وفي قرارة نفسه واثق أن الله سبحانه وتعالى ميسر له حفظ القرآن لا محالة.
And inside him, deep inside him, he knows and he believes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the memorization of the Quran easy for him. And this is impossible.
ثم أخذ بالأسباب المشروعة في كل يوم يحفظ ويراجع ويعرض المصحف على شيخ متقن. نعم.
And then after this, he then starts using those causes or those avenues which Allah has placed. Meaning, he memorizes every single day and he revises every single day and he reads to a sheikh who is proficient in his memorization or his recitation.
نعم